Because I just feel like God's here and I want to change our perspective on some things. Or give us God's perspective. The writer of Hebrews, you can, Paul, however you want to feel this morning. I want to share a few things because I know that there are several that are going through several things. Thank you for your confidence in trusting us. I will never break your confidence. But as a whole, I know that there are a lot of folks with a lot of things on their plate in the sanctuary. And so I want to share a few thoughts with you this morning that I believe that the Lord will help us with. Hebrews chapter number 6 and verse number 15, the Bible says, "And after he had patiently endured," this is all speaking about Abraham in the Old Testament. You read of his life, his leaving his homeland, everything that he knew about as being raised in idol worship, but he leaves because he's seeking God. Him and his wife doesn't have children. They have their nephew a lot with them. I'm sure that they loved him like a child. But he kind of goes and does his own thing. But God speaks to Abraham's heart and tells him that he's going to give him a son. And we know the story, that his seed is going to be great. And so the Bible says that after Abraham had patiently endured, you know, sometimes there is a process from being promised to possessing. And sometimes that long journey is rigorous. And sometimes it can be full of faith-trying circumstances. So here it is. We know that God has promised us so much. God has promised us that one day the vessel of our life is going to sail into the harbor of heaven. And we're going to be ever there for eternity. And it's going to be a wonderful and it's going to be a safe place. However, before we anchor in the shores of heaven, we may need to throw our anchors out on this voyage between here and eternity. Mm-hmm. And I want to tell you this morning that as Abraham anchored in the Rock of Ages, though he looked forward to the Rock of Ages, you and I look back to the Rock of Ages, and we can anchor in him when the storms of life are sailing, are getting difficult. What happens when the captain of the ship sees that he's in treacherous waters? He'll throw down an anchor. And it will keep him while all the waves are going crazy and the winds are going crazy. There are also times where he knows he's going to get a catch. And he knows that there are good treasures below, Brother Craig. So he will drop down anchor because he knows that there are good treasures here. I want to tell you that you may be in a situation in your life where you feel like the anchor has been dropped. You may say, the seas are tough. And maybe the seas are placid. You're like, why am I here? I want to tell you that God has chosen for you to anchor down because God has a good place for you. God gives you an anchor because it keeps you from drifting. Amen. You may not be in your spiritual journey where you need to be. Had not God dropped the anchor down right here in February 5th of 2017. And maybe you say, I don't want to be anchored here. God knows that the contingency of you going on your journey well, the necessary thing is for the anchor to be dropped here. There's a treasure here. There's a catch here. Maybe it's a place where the storms, amen, won't overtake your vessel. You will not be capsized. So God says, here, I want you to drop your anchor. Whatever it may be. For some of us, it may be just in the, Brother Josh, the rat race of raising family. Some of you, maybe it's in health situations. Maybe it's in situations you didn't ask for. God knows. Maybe some of you, it's financial situations. Maybe some of you, it's job situations or changes in life. I don't know. I'm saying, but the anchor is dropped because God knows that your vessel needs to be anchored here. So interesting, several years ago, Truth came out with a song, and I want to read the lyrics to you in the next few seconds here. And the lyric says this: John has a new way of looking at life. He's tired of his jobs, his kids, and his wife. Sends a secret to his success. Was it leaving and finding himself? Now he's someone to somebody else. You say we've reasoned a new way of truth, and you're calling in the spiritual God, me, pursuit. But I say, what if we fall into the bottom of the well, thinking that we've risen to the top of the mountain? And what if we're knocking at the gates of hell, thinking that we're heaven bound? And what if we're spending our lives thinking of ourselves when we should have been thinking of each other? What if we've reached up to touch the ground to find that we're living life upside down? We've got a program for saving the earth while unborn children are denied the right to birth. One child is blessed and the other cursed. Have we made this world better or worse? Now the life of a tree comes first. What if you said we reason to a new age of life, and you're telling me what used to be wrong is now right? But I say, what if we've fallen to the bottom of the well? You see, sometimes we think God's logistics of living life is different, so we stop pursuing God in the middle of everything, and we start pursuing ourselves. I want to tell you something. The situations that we are in and we are living, amen, they're really not about us, but they're about the glory of God. You are here in your current situation that the glory of God may be magnified in your life. And so sometimes I think that we need to realize, like Abraham, this isn't about me, but it's that the promise of God may be fulfilled in me and God may be glorified in my life. The new age, the new way of thinking of things is thinking about me and I. God is not worried about you thinking about you, yourself, and I. God is worried about you anchoring in His promise and allowing the glory of God to be magnified in whatever situation you are in. Yes. Do you hear me this morning? I don't want to upset anybody. No one likes sometimes our current condition, and we think, why me? Me, me, me. But God is saying all the time, I have promised that I will never leave you, nor forsake you. Didn't the Spirit of God speak that this morning? I'm with you always, every step of your journey. This isn't about you or me. This is about that God may be glorified and His promises may be fulfilled in us, because we have an anchor for our soul. Paul goes on down to write, wherein God, willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise the immutability, or the fact that God never changes. He always keeps His promise. I want you to think out for a moment. What are some of the best times of your life where you felt the presence of God, the power of God, the promise of God? You've been in church. Life is good. And man, it's easy to swing from the fence. And it's easy to have faith. And it's easy to be excited. But God does not change, even when life changes. And God wants you to know that one thing that is immutable, throw the anchor in Him. He will keep you when life seas are placid, or when they are very full of waves. God will keep you. Of His counsel confirmed it by an oath, that by two immutable things in which it was impossible for God to lie, God said this: I'm sending my Messiah, and my Messiah, He will redeem you of your sins. And so Paul is saying something to these believers. He's saying, listen, there is a new way. The Messiah has come. And he begins to reference about us having a high priest. The priesthood of Aaron could only do one thing. They could minister and take the place of the people. They could go in to the temple or the tabernacle, but only the high priest could go into the holy and the holy of holies. And he would do it once a year. And he would be robed in such a way that he would have 12 gems over his shoulders and over his heart that represented the nation of Israel. He would go in as a representation of the people. And so Paul was saying, listen, God has promised that he would keep us and that he would send us a Messiah. And the Messiah came. He didn't just minister to the people, but he went with all his heart and he shouldered the load of all the people. And he went to the cross to be the supreme sacrifice. He went to the Holy of Holies so that you and I could go there. Amen. So that you and I could enter into the presence of God. Not once a year, but whenever we had need, we had access to the presence of God. So the anchor of God is sure this morning that you and I have access to the presence of God. Someone doesn't do it for us, but you and I can go boldly before the presence of God with whatever our needs are. Talk about an anchor for the soul. Listen, I don't have to go running to you. I don't have to go running to one individual to go and take my needs before God the Father. But God has given me access before His presence. And so no matter what sea of life I am sailing, I have access to the presence of God. This morning, if there's anything I want you to know, is your soul can be anchored in the rock of ages. No matter what life brings, no matter what situation someone else causes us, our soul is anchored in the rock of ages. And so this morning, let your anchor be sure. Brother Dennis sang it this morning. You didn't even know what I was going to preach on. Be very sure. Be very sure your anchor holds and grips the solid rock. Do you know how crazy anchors are nowadays? You know, we look at that anchor, the picture, you know, that we see in our mind, and you think about that being cast out, and it can go to the depths of the ocean, and it grabs hold of rocks, it grabs hold of ground, and it holds the vessel. Anchors are so complicated nowadays that they actually have the ability to wind and drill themselves into the ground. That's how complicated they are. The captain knows that he can keep that vessel from capsizing because he can anchor it down. This morning, Jesus Christ already spoke through His Word, through the power of the Holy Ghost, through the writer of Hebrews, that there is an anchor in our soul. Amen. We will not be capsized in this voyage of life. There will come a day when we will make it all the way home. Every one of us, if we keep the faith and keep our relationship right with Jesus Christ, we will anchor in the harbors of home on heaven's shore. But right now, we are sailing. And you may say, I want to sail, and I don't want to be anchored here so close to God. Drops the anchor because He knows that right here is where you need love and gentleness and joy and patience and peace. God knows that there is a treasure here. Many years ago, I remember going out deep sea fishing, and so many, I don't know where we were, everything looked the same to me. We lost the vision of land, but Sister Jenny, the captain knew where we were going, and he knew where the place was where the fish usually were. And so he anchored down there. There were some times where it was rocky. Amen. A few times I've been out, it was rocky, made my belly upset for a while, had to go lay down. But there was other times where it was so placid, it was like a mirror everywhere, but it didn't matter. We were anchored in the place where the treasure was. This morning, do you have enough confidence in God of knowing that He's directing your life, that you are anchored in the place where the treasure is? You are, Brother Craig. God knows what treasure you need for life right now. And though your voyage isn't over, Brother Long, God may anchor you here because here is where the treasure is. Trust in this. Trust in this. See, when the presence of God is here so strong, a reminder to every individual, every one of us in our voyage. You know what happens when that ship is there in the ocean? And maybe there is some rocking of the way. You get the bow is shifting. All the boards are shifting, right? Don't worry about the noise. The anchor holds. I know life can throw you lots of noises, and it can be scary and overwhelming. I'm not worried about the bow. Amen. It has been built well, nail by nail. It has been built very well by Jesus Christ. And I'm confident that the anchor, it holds. It holds. It holds. No. Let your anchor hold this morning. I've anchored my soul in the haven of rest. I'll sail the seas no more. Is your soul anchored in the haven of rest? Are you anchored in Jesus this morning? He's the anchor. He's the rock. He's in the vessel. It's all right. Even when it seems like he's asleep, he's still in control of the storm. Amen. He is in our vessel. And our anchor holds sure. Would you do this morning? Would you stand right where you are? It's not so placid for me right now. Seas, the billows, are we rolling? Would you know that you're kept here? That you're kept. Maybe you say, Brother Seville, but it's not even quite that way for me. It's just hard to navigate. It seems like there's rocks everywhere. You know what they do? They'll throw the anchor down and they'll navigate the vessel. Because of where the anchor is, around the rocks. They'll pull it up, and they'll throw it down again, Sister King. They'll navigate around those tedious areas. Would you know that the anchor is navigating you this morning? So whether it's placid, or navigation, or rough seas, would you do this morning? Would you just close your eyes? Would you lift up your hand? And would you grab onto God and say, God, I trust you this morning. The anchor holds. The anchor holds. Amen. Would you just say that to God? God, I trust you. I'm anchored in you. And this is not about me, but it's about you being glorified. And the anchor holds this morning. The anchor holds. Hallelujah, Jesus. The anchor holds. God, we're anchored in the rock of ages. And so we trust you, God. We trust you. Hallelujah. God, hold us. God, may we find the treasure. May we find the catch this morning. May we benefit from where you've anchored us. God, may we know that we've anchored this morning in the storms, that we will not capsize. But our anchor is secure in you. God, may we know that we can navigate because the anchor, God, it navigates us. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad this morning that we can be anchored in the rock of ages? The anchor holds. The anchor holds. Brother, it's going to keep you. Sister, there's something there you will not capsize, but God has a treasure to catch for you. For the anchor is holding you. Find it. Amen. Be confident. The anchor holds. Amen. Don't you appreciate God's presence this morning? Amen. I love every one of you. I want to see you grow your faith. God wants to do great things. I'm going to ask this morning, and we're in closing, just remain standing. Brother Craig, Brother Josh, if you come this morning.